In this video, we are going to discuss about array processors. The name itself specifies the meaning. Instead of a single processor, we have a collection of processors. So array processors are mainly useful in order to improve the performance of a system. Mainly there are two types of array processors are available. The first one is attached array processor. The second one is SIMD array processor. First, let's see about attached array processor. Here, an additional processor is attached to the computer in order to improve the performance of the system. Let us assume that we are executing a vast number of instructions. In that occasion, it is not possible to execute all those instructions with the help of our computer. If we use our computer, then our computer may take days and weeks in order to execute those vast number of instructions. So that's why, in order to improve the performance of the system, an attached array processor is attached to the computer. So let's see this diagram. So this is general purpose computer and we have attached the array processor. This is a peripheral device, just like a peripheral device. We attached this array processor to the computer. And we have I/O interface. So I/O interface is mainly useful in order to resolve the differences between the computer and this processor. This computer may be slow, whereas this processor is extremely faster. So in order to resolve those differences, we are using this interface, I/O interface. Next, we have main memory. So the contents of the general purpose register will be stored in the main memory, and the contents of the attached array processor are stored in the local memory. So if there are a lacks of instructions, then from this main memory, we have a high speed memory to memory bus. So with the help of this high speed memory bus, all these instructions, the vast number of instructions, are to be transferred to the local memory. So this attached array processor will execute those vast number of instructions. So once those instructions execution is completed, so once again with the help of this high speed memory bus, that result or those instructions will be transferred to the main memory. So we are using attached array processor mainly to improve the performance of a computer. Now let's see about SIMD array processor. SIMD stands for single instruction stream. M stands for multiple. So multiple. D stands for data stream. So single instruction stream, multiple data stream. So that means instructions are always stored in main memory. Whereas here we have multiple data stream. So single instruction stream means we have only single main memory. So in main memory, all those instructions will be stored. Whereas multiple data stream means processor can execute those instructions. So we can have multiple processors. So SIMD stands for a single main memory but multiple processors. Here PE1 means processor element 1. So this is one processor. PE2 means second processor element. PEN means the last processor element. Each processor element contains ALU, arithmetic logic unit, and some pipelines, arithmetic pipeline, multiplier pipeline, and some registers. So all those information will be available in each processing element. And this M1 is nothing but a local memory associated with PE1. This M2 means a local memory associated with PE2 likewise. Here we have master control unit. This master control unit controls all the processing units. This master control unit decodes the instructions and generates the control signals based upon the operation. Let us assume that we want to execute an instruction like this. C is equal to AI plus BA. So it decodes the instruction. It comes to know that the instruction needs addition operation. So the plus will be sent to all the processing elements here. So here SAM instruction will be sent to all the processing elements, and all the processing elements will execute the same instruction simultaneously. Okay, so let us assume that we want to execute this instruction where I value is something like this 1, 2, 3, so on here. So then what will happen is, first that instruction will be stored in the main memory, and from the main memory the corresponding information will be transmitted to the corresponding local memory. So A1, B1 will be stored in M1, A2, B2 will be stored in M2, A3, B3 will be stored in AN, BN will be stored in MN, like that. So this processing element will perform the corresponding addition operation. A1 plus B1, PE2 performs A2 plus B2, PN performs AN plus BN. So once that addition operation is performed, the corresponding result is transferred to the main memory. So like this, we can improve the performance of the system by taking multiple processors. So this is about array processing.